basically, measures of central tendency, we have three things. That is what I was talking about, the average, how the data is concentrated to into a center. If this is the data set, this is the central tendency, and these two are the dispersion. These two are the dispersion and the middle value. This is the central tendency. Okay, that is just a graphical representation. So we have measures of central tendency, three things. One is the mean, one is median, and the last one is mode. Okay, so mean is the most accurate value. If we are not able to take the mean, or the data set is in a such a way that we can't take the mean and it is not giving an accurate value, we can go for median or mode. So mean is very easy, it is just average. That is, mean is denoted by x bar. This is called bar. So x bar is equal to sigma x by n. Sorry, that is a total score divided by the number of observations. So the mean is equal to sigma x by n. So we have a example. For a very simple example, it is, we have a data set, values are 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the mean would be 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6. So the total number of observations are 5. That is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 20 divided by 5, it is 4. So if it is a exam with a score 2, 5 participants are scoring 2, 3, 4 and 5 and 6. So on average, every student is scoring marks 4. It doesn't mean that all have scored mark 4. Only 1% have scored mark 4. 1%, 2% scored above, 2% scored below. But we are saying that on average, the score is 4. That is, mean value is 4. Okay, that is the most accurate value of a central tendency. Usually we take mean. In most of the research, we take mean and standard deviation. If you go search any article, you can see mean and standard deviation. You can see something like this, 2 plus or minus 1.8 or 2.3 plus or minus 2.1. So this is nothing but, this is central tendency and this is measure of dispersion. This will be mean and this is standard deviation. Okay, so that is a measure of central tendency. That is the first one, mean.